In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Today I want to speak about the purity of Saint Mary. When we speak about purity, we mean the purity of the heart, the mind, the body, the relations, the purity in everything. She is always pure. Since she was a child, she was very pure. That's why she was chosen by God to be his mother. And when the archangel came telling her that you will be the mother of God, she told him as if she is reminding him, I had a vow. I will not know any man. I do not know a man. So she expressed her heart that she will live in virginity. And that's like a deal with the Lord. So the archangel confirmed the idea that this birth is not just like anyone. It's a miraculous gift from the Lord. The Holy One will be born out of her, is the Son of God. So she was happy because she kept herself in purity and lived with the virginity vow for her life. That's why according to the tradition of the church, we always say that she was virgin before and also after the labor of the Lord Jesus Christ in a miraculous way. But the purity is not just to marry or not to marry. Even the Christian marriage is purity in nature because that's the gift of God. But she was always pure in her heart. She did not hate anyone. Although she was persecuted by the Jew people, and she suffered a lot, and many people, you know, hurt her in many ways. Herod, he killed many of the children in her village, and Pilate and Herod shared in killing her greatest son, our Lord Jesus Christ. But because of the purity of her heart, she was always praying for everyone. She lived all the commandments of the Bible. She forgave everyone. Her heart is just full of love to everyone. That's why we always pray to her to help us to forgive others, to keep our hearts as pure as her heart. And because of the power of purity, this is so much related to the power of prayer. That's the words of the fathers. They always commented on, if you want to have a powerful prayer, you have to have this pure heart. When you love God from all your heart and love everyone, even the enemies, now your prayers are really strong. And God will listen carefully to whatever you pray for, because your will is just, you know, the same will of God. The purity of the heart of our Lord Jesus Christ is given to his mother, because we all believe that the purity of the heart is not only the will of man or the part of man to struggle to catch, but it's also the grace of God. So the grace of God worked with the will of Saint Mary to have this pure heart in all aspects. Also, Saint Mary was such a child who loved so much to keep the word of God in her heart. She memorizes many parts of the Old Testament. She kept herself in praying psalms all the time. So keeping the word of God, being busy in mind with the word of God, this helps so much with the purity of the heart and mind, and definitely the behavior outside, because the purification of the heart will come out with whatever you say and whatever you do after. So the purity of Saint Mary is a great example for all Christians to fight, to struggle, to have this purity in their heart and to love their enemies as exactly as shown and presented in the life of Saint Mary. Also, when Saint Mary was standing before the cross of her beloved son, she, you know, suffered a lot. She had this sword in her heart, but though she kept herself praying silently. That's, you know, the perfect model of a pure heart who never, you know, curse anyone or being angry with anyone, but accepting the will of God, whatever it cost her. So we need the intercession of Saint Mary. May God give us the same purity in our hearts. God bless you all. Amen.